what all about we have discussed yesterday. So now we'll go to the methods of the string one by one. Okay, so there are a lot of methods that I discussed yesterday. What you can do, you can just write on help, and then you can see the str. You will get all the methods what string is having on. Okay, nice. So let's say this is just a word, let's say machine. And you want to make a string in some lowercase. Now you have two options there. To make a string in a lowercase, you have two of the methods. One is called as your lower particularly, and the other can be the swap case. What is good evening? Yeah, good evening. Where was I? Yeah. So like if you convert this in the lower is nothing but lower, and that's all past the parenthesis, and you will be getting machine over there. Similarly, see, you can see the lower definition, what is lower particularly. So if you see I, E, okay, L will be down. And see this, lower will return a copy of a string converted into the lower case. So you'll get a copy of such string which will be in lower cases. So what I said, there is one more function called as make the cases. The first one, you can see this in the first, this case fold. Okay. So this will return you the, actually this will particularly give you the cases in the, you can say lower version, right? So like for the lowercase and the case fold will work similarly. Okay. Now the next method is like you are having lower, similarly you are having upper. Like if you write something in the lower and you say this to be in upper, so that will be an upper one. Okay. So I'm writing all one by one, and you can just see on how it works. So let's say this is a sentence, and a sentence first letter is always capital, right? So to make only the first letter capital, we'll use capitalize. And you will be getting the first one as the capital, rest everything remains the same, right? But now let's say this is a two term. That is artificial intelligence. All right. So this is okay. Yeah, more. So this is like two terms, right? And see, these words are individual, some good words, right? So artificial A should be capital, and intelligence I should be capital. So both should be capital, right? Here was like for the first one should be capital, and like in artificial intelligence, both should be in the capital. So what you can do is you can write on the title, and the title will just make these things both in the capital. That is, every word first letter will be in capital. Okay. Now let's say you have written something. Let's say giving gaps or spaces. Let's say that your string is having some spaces in the beginning and in the ending, and you want to remove these spaces. So you will be using strip method. So that will particularly remove the gaps of this string. Okay, that is from the, if you only print this one, if you see, if you just print this one, you will be getting gaps as similar as you are getting. But if you use this strip method, there you will be getting the gaps removed. All right, that is how it works. Now, the next is like, let's say you might be knowing about something called as, let's say this is T. Right, toggle case, no? Basically you combine something. some mixture of like ascending and descending in some, or you can say upper and lower in some unordered case, right? So for that you will have to do swap case. Now in swap case, what happens? Every particular like case will be just swapped, or you can say just reverse. Like the lower will become upper, the upper will be lower, and like so. Okay. So you can see the toggle case. This follows the like swap case method. Okay. So these are some of the common methods what we use. Now there is some one more method like called as split. That is very important actually. That is really used in very various kind of things. So I'll be discussing this split. Is very important. Okay. So let's say you are having a website. Let's say to be. So let's say it's to be thieves.in, right? And you are saying this to be split by win. So you are saying split by win. So what you will get, do you know? So, 1 second, let me write it as dot. That's nice, yeah. So, if you write it by dot, what happens? It will split every of the thing from this dot. Like this, wherever it will find a dot, it will just separate up the things from that. Okay. Now, this concept is used very much to various places, like you when you upload anything in the any of the websites, like when you upload files, and if there is any limitations, like they only accept this particular file name or this like this format, or like let's say you are uploading something which only we are uploading a resume, right? Let's say you are uploading a resume and it only supports, let's say the website is saying that it will only support PDF format. It will only be supporting that PDF format, and you want to upload in DOC doc format. That would obviously not take if it is having some restrictions over there. Now let's say you want PDF, you want only the PDF versions. You don't want any of the doc method or something like that, right? Only you want the PDF ones. So like how you take it, let's take the input from the user and let's say him to enter a file. That is nothing but he will be giving a file name, right? So, and also what we did say is like I'll split his entry with this dot, right? Why? Because whenever we upload any files, we have some extensions, right? That can be CSV, PDF, JPG, PNG, doc, Excel, anything. So let's take this and this, let's take the user. And yesterday we did the slicing, right? So we'll see -1 on that. Okay, that is the last element. And we'll see whether the last element is PDF or not. If it is PDF, then we'll accept the thing. And if it is not PDF, then we'll just leave an error that this is not a suitable format and you should not continue with this, right? So let's run this. So it's asking that user is equals to enter a file. So let's write anything. Let's say this is resume dot doc. So you can see the user -1 is nothing but the doc. If you see the user, what will be there? There will be resume and the doc, right? So this particular dot has been removed because you have split these things with the reference of this dot. So let's say again you have run this program and you say PDF, and this time your thing would be PDF. Oh, sorry. Let's see. So this time, like for the resume and PDF, like okay. This is one of the most important method. Many a times we use this. I'll give you a very good example of how, but later on, that's okay. So we saw some of the methods like, okay, Even if, let's say, if you have some names over there, like if you have some names, or let's say you have some colors list, let me be green, blue, red, yellow, like this, right? So you can even check on some things over there, like whether it is lying or not. We'll discuss this in this particularly, let it be there. So how many methods we have seen, right? Title, lowercase, bold, upper. So there is one center, capitalize, we have seen count. Okay, see, let's say this is a occurrence. So find the occurrence of the word O in this sentence. Hey, this is a string that is asking, find the occurrence of word O in the string. It's nice. So what you will do, you will use count. And in the count, you will find O. So it says in the whole sentence, O has been repeated for 4 times. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Where is the 4th one? Here, 4th. Okay. Like this, you can just use this count. You can pass on the parameter what you want to check, and that will be done. Similarly, if I want to find this particular sentence, if I say that this dot index O, so what you see, index of 9. So let's count from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So what you understand that whenever you find any particular thing which is having more than one occurrence, right, and you are finding the index number, you will get always the first index number. Okay, that is important. Always the first one you will get. In your like IBM exam, a question will come like, there would be one name or there's something like, what is it? Let it be any particular name, right? Let's say Stephen Hawkins. Okay, so it will say you to find, the find and index works as similar, right? There's only one difference on that. I'll brief it later onwards. So there is only one in particular difference I'll discuss now, right? So let's say I'm searching for this E, right? So what I see that this E is in 0, 1 and the second position, right? But if I say I want to find G, so it says minus 1. This is very important, right? It says minus, if I'm finding G, it's saying like minus 1, okay? But if I do the same thing and I use index, I'll get an error over there. That is substring not found, right? Substring has not been found yet. Okay, so this is important again, because see, in index, we say that both of the work is same, right? Both find the index values. But the only difference is, if you find such a substring which is not present inside the string, right? Then the index parameter, or say index function, will give you an error, right? But as if you go with the same thing and you use the find one, right, the find function, that will return you the value of minus 1. So that is necessary to, like, you can just get on these things, right? Okay. Then we have some next function. Let's see.
So,
this. Yes.
Like, I'm trying to take out the output, but wherever it's set it input in the, like, the square bracket, there's an asterisk coming over there. How do I remove that?
Got it. Do one thing. Click on this stop button. Okay, click on that particular cell. Click on that particular cell and then click on the stop. Okay. Once it stop, click on again run. Done?
Yep.
Alright. Okay. So there are some of the methods like how we print on something. Yeah. Yesterday I also deal up with those things, right? So let's say this is x and this is y. Okay, let's say this is x equals 20. And I want to print this thing. So how can I print? I can print like this is x equals to 20. This will correct or wrong? This is wrong actually, right? You can print it as like x is equals to 20. So again, there is a keyword, cannot be an expression. Okay, so what you can write, that is x is equals to x. And that equals to be given in the parameters, and then you can give a comma and write x, that is x is equals to x. X equals 20, right? So you have several methods to print something like that. Let me say, I'm writing this print x, or let's say percent d equals percent d, and this percent d stands for an integer value, right? Similarly, percent f stand for a float value, percent s stand for a string value. So let's say I am printing this percent d equals to percent d. Now what are the values of percent d? Now let's say this to be x, don't write it as, okay? So x is equals to percent d. Now what is the value of percent d? That is percent x. Understood? That will be percent x. So you run this, you will be getting x is equals to 20. So d particularly stands for the, like you are writing an integer value there. But if you write f there, so you'll be getting 20.0 over there. That is, your particular thing will be converted in the float and then will be printed there. Understood? So let it be let it be f. Now let's say this y is equals to 20.5. Right? And I'm printing this y equals percent b. Now what should be my value? 20, right? That is an integer value because I said d stands for integer, so 20.5 integer will be 20. But if I say this y is equals to 20.5, now you will be getting exact value of this y. Sorry. Sorry, this is y and this should be percent s. So you can see the exact value of like 20.5, right? So but if you write here f, that will be again 20.5 and then you will get the zeros over there. Okay, this is how these things works. Okay, so you can print on like this. So there is one more method called as format in the strings. So there you can write it as like, you want this to be print and then you are saying x and y is equals to this and this. Then you write some format and then you pass the values of x and y. This x and y will be entered, this x and y value will be entered, first x and then first y will be entered over there. So x and y is equals to 20 and 20.5. Similarly, you can write this statement for this. So like, don't do this one. Like many a times what happens, student does it like this is x and y equals to percent e and percent s. Let it be percent s on both the sides. Mostly what students do is like they once write percent x and then they give a comma and then write percent y. That is wrong actually. Okay. So you give 1% value, you put a parenthesis and enter your values in the parenthesis. That is like percent x, 1%, and then pass on the different values like you'll be editing the format one. You'll get x and y equals. Okay. So these are some of the methods, like important ones of this string. Okay. We have index and alphanumeric, alpha, ASCII, decimal, digit. Like there are a lot of them. Okay, you can explore one by one. Like alphanumeric is something where if you say this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, if you say this is an alpha number, so this say this is an like string but and having some numerical values, right? Or having some numericals. You can say like this is, let's say this is a word and you are checking whether this is a digit or not. So that is false, this is not a digit. Okay. Meanwhile, if you check this, okay, like this you can find. And for finding the ASCII code of any particular thing, you can just pass on this order and then you can say to find the ASCII code. Okay. That is, you can like go and do with the strings. That is important. Okay. Now we'll learn something different. So these are the methods of the string, how string works and okay. Now giving you a practical examples, let's say you want to create a, let's say for example, you want to create a Yahoo account or like you want to create, let's say you want to share someone, you want to share some like your profile link, like your, let's say your Instagram profile link, you want to share your Instagram profile link to someone, right? So how does that do actually? So what is your profile link, how your profile link could be like HTTPS and then it could be www.instagram.com user and then you have like a data over there. Right, then you like write your username, then you have your user. How many times this user might not be there? So you write your username over there, right? This is actually how it works. Like this is where you are, how you go to this thing. So this is like happens. Okay, now let's say if I split this on the terms of this, what is the value? It is https instagram.com slash username, right? This is like this, you are getting some two of the things. What do you say to separate this with dot? What is the value? You are getting some Instagram and then you are getting com slash the username. And what if you do with this particular slash? So you're getting HTTPS, single like particular string, then Instagram.com and then the username. Okay. So like when you upload, when some websites want your like LinkedIn profile or something like that, when you write in the place of a LinkedIn profile, when you upload a Facebook profile, why it not accept actually? So this search is actually, let's say they search like if the URL dot split and they will say if somewhere. Okay, so actually see what happens. I'll write the program there. So if if this Instagram lies in this thing. Then they say like, okay, like actually this except. If it is not there, right, so what happens in that case? And it says invalid link, something like that, right? So, like, if it is correct, then it is accepted, right? But in place, let's say I have written here Facebook and I upload this. So, this will be an invalid link, okay? So, a basic practical implication, right? So, what happens actually, you when you split this by a slash, so this is taking like one slash and one slash is there, so this will be breaked up and like you'll be getting there. Now, how a website see, like how you can see the security level, how you can see the security levels of any website, is this, whenever you see like HTTPS, now this S saying that this is a secured, like this is an SSL certificate, this website is having an SSL certificate, TLS certification like that, okay. But if it is not having only HTTP, like that is not secure, that is an unsecure website, okay. So how to see, like whenever you search for anything, you get some HTTPS and like something in there, right? This is a local host, this is not like, if you see, so if your connection to the site is not secure, okay, because this is not an online site, this is a just like a local host where you can act, okay. So attackers like do some things here. Now, but when you see some good sites over there, like when you see something which is having like, when let's say for this drive link, so here if you click, you can see connection is secure and like this is having SSL and all these things, right? So that is nice when you go for this, all these things, right? When you see YouTube and all those, right? So those are having SSLs, okay. So how to see, like when you want to see the let's say how to find all string methods as you done earlier. Okay, help of str. That's it. Okay, sorry. Write one more here. Just give one more inverted. Sorry, the colon. Quotes there. Okay. Okay. So URL dot split. Similarly, let's say your URL is this. You're having a URL, and let's say this time your URL is HTTP. What happens many a times, it checks your internet, and it could happen, or it would happen, might happen with you guys, that most of the time you are opening a website and you might get that your connection to the site is not private and something like that. Okay, that is due to the security levels actually. So let's say this is an HTTP site, and this is always, a site is always like this, right? So let's it be www.google.com. Okay, this is like google.com, very basic one I'm writing on. See now what I say, I'll say if the URL when splitted by, when, or let's say if you find HTTPS in the URL dot split, sorry, split, and let's say this to be this, okay? If you find HTTPS, then it's, you just say that this is a secure website. Or else this is an insecure website. So this is an insecure one. Why? Because when you check your URL.split by this colon, so when you check this, you will be getting the first element, that is HTTP. Okay. And this HTTP is not found in this, okay, I didn't find any HTTPS in this one, okay. So that is the particular thing, this is like, a lot of things are used and a lot of things are fine just using this particular, you can say split, okay. Not always this in method is used, many a times it could be used like if, url.find https is equals to minus 1. If it is like that, then again the same things come here and look like that. Okay. If the url.find is having this. Like the index will give some errors. Let me write some prime. So invalid syntax. Oh shit, this should be here like this. So, so this is an insecure website, right? Because you didn't find minus one. So if you see this, the value, that is minus one. Because HTTPS is not present in there, right? HTTPS is not found in that particular string. So this work is many places this work is like that, right? So what do you think, like whenever you go, okay, someone escaped. So what, like whenever you go to some places or right, if you just log in somewhere, this happens actually, okay? Everywhere this happens. It asks you like for the instagram.com at the rate of like you write your things over there, like username and passwords. This is like how it happens. Let's say you are taking a logging in a Gmail account and like you are using some different emails over there. Let's say you are asked to print this email. Enter email, okay. You are asked to enter email, and if I say this email of minus one, or if I say if gmail.com is not in this email, then I'll just print invalid. Invalid email, okay, or else I'll print out that this is or else we'll go continue with the passwords, right? So if I enter an email, let's say to be xyz at the rate of yahoo.com. You are entering yahoo.co.in. It says it's an invalid email because see, my domain is now for gmail.com and Gmail is not getting here, right? So that is an invalid, because if you see your one more thing is left like this. So let's say xyz at the rate of yahoo.com. So like when you see your email, you can find that you are having xyz and yahoo.com, and I am searching for minus one. You can even find it like the email of minus one should be equals to like your domain name. So I have written that if gmail.com is not found here, then this is a wrong one, right? Because Gmail email ID will obviously have gmail.com, right? That is the difference, and these are the methods actually what the string is having. Okay. Now we'll go to different data type. See. So we have seen a lot of things. Whenever we split it there, we are getting something in boxes, right? In some boxes over there. What are these things called as? Okay, these things are called as list. Now, list are like a collection of heterogeneous data types. And when I say heterogeneous data type, that means that it collects actually different type of data, like different types of data. Like it can be an integer, float, string, boolean, like anything, okay? So list is particularly a collection of various, or you can say heterogeneous data types. And here what happens, an element can be repeated on. Now these are very important things. When I say element can be repeated on, that is, okay, you should mention it like, and you should remind it with that. Because while making projects, what happened, we use these things most of the time. And students do errors here itself, okay. So like we are going to start the list, right? So what I said, list is a collection of a heterogeneous data which can store various type of data types, and can here the like values can be duplicated, and this is written in square brackets, okay? So we have made one list, that is colors. Let's say I'm again making a list. Let's say this to be, okay, let's say some practical things over there. So let's take this as any practical examples to be, let's say this is COVID, right? So COVID affected cities. Okay, so let's say this is a list of COVID. Now I'll write the cities which has been affected by the COVID, like for the first time, and then like so on, right? So for that I have one data. I'll have to see that actually. Because I actually don't know what are the cities which has been affected for the first time. So we'll look on first data over there. No, not this. No, not even this. D12 is not there. D11 is not there. It might be the data science ones. Data science. Once again, this food on. Let's see on. Yeah. There might I get 12. Still not there. Okay, that was somewhere. That is actually somewhere. I think I have kept in my downloads. COVID individual details. If I see on. So let's see which cities has been like affected for the first. Open. Okay, so like the 31 I'm having, what is the name? Okay, let's take it. It's Kerala, then Delhi, then Telangana, Rajasthan, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. Okay, fine. So let's take the first was the Kerala. Okay, then comes this, I think Telangana is there. Right. Remember guys, Kerala, Delhi, Telangana, Rajasthan and Haryana. Alright. Kerala, Delhi, Haryana. Okay. Let it be three. Okay. So these are the first three states which has been affected by the COVID. Okay. Like according to that data. I'm not like guessing it according to that data. So see, this is a list, like here the elements can be repeated also. So let's say I'm saying the type of this COVID. So if I see the type of this COVID, would I see that this is a kind of list? So you can find out this list over here. Similarly, see what happens now, day after day, this like states have been going in the added up, right? The states have been added up the day after day, and like something is being added up, right? if a practical example I consider, let's consider a glass of water, okay, and you are adding some kerosene to it, right? What happens? Water will get up to the kerosene level, right? Kerosene will float over the water, and like that's it. Natural physics, by and forth, right? So that is like every time when you put something liquid over there with a very less density, you'll be getting it up over there, right? Right? This is how list works on. Whenever you add something, it will get added here. There are mostly the methods, only if you use the insert method. But if you just use add anything, that will be added up in the end of that. And that is a very great advantage you will have of this one later onwards when you work on projects and all. Okay. That is having a very great advantage to it. No? So this is a list, let's say. Or let's say this is a songs list. Let's write some singer's name. Okay. Now I have written some three singers' name, like whose song I listen, right? Now let's say I recently listened to one new singer and his songs was very nice, and so I want to add him up in my list, right? How you do actually? Yeah, what you do is in Spotify or JioSaavn, what you do actually? You just click on that third option and that is a like song for you, right? So actually you add the song in your like list, okay? That is a library over there. A playlist is there for your particular one in your own songs application, right? So you actually add those particular songs in your list, right? So how you just click a heart over there, you don't do any programming over there. So to add anything in your list manually, like in the Python, to add any value in your list, what you do, you just write, you have three methods. So you can use append. Now let's say for adding one single value, okay, like in the whole day I listen, let's say I got to listen this Shreya's song, okay, and I save the song dot append Shreya. So for the next time, if I will see my songs, I'll see Shreya over there, that is in the last position. That's nice, okay. And let's say the next day is Sunday and I'm having a holiday. So I kept on listening more over the songs. I like listening songs, making songs, right? So let's say I listen a lot of songs, and then there I listen some 2-3 singles very well, and I like all the songs there. Okay. So see, for adding some multiple elements in your list now, let's say this is in the songs, you want to add some multiple elements. So there you'll be using extend. Okay. And this is a kind of list here. And now let's say I listen to the song of Darshan, I just go with the song of Vishal, and let's say with the Sodu, and like these things, right? So I got to listen to the songs of this person, this personality, right? And when now I'll print the songs, I can see these things over like Ajit, AR, Revansa, Arman, Shreya, Darshan, Vishal, and all of them right there over. Okay, so the values is like added up one by one. You can see like Shreya is there, then I added Darshan, Vishal, Sonu, and that has been added like up to the Shreya. Okay, so this is like what I'm saying. Every time what happened, the thing will be added in the last of like your list. Okay, you'll be getting everything in the last of like your list. Okay, now let's say among of this one, one should be my favorite, right? One should be my favorite one. So what I'll do, I'll keep listening the songs of my favorite one in the starting, right? I'll always start my song set with the favorite one, right? So among this one, my favorite is AR Rahman, right? So that I'll write, I listen a new song, let's say, and I want, the song is very nice, right? And the singer is like AR Rahman. So what I'll do, I'll just insert that song in the first place, right? Whenever I start my playlist, I should listen that first song, should be that, okay? So for adding anything in a specific location, right, in a specific location, because these are not adding in a specific location, you are getting everything in the last of that. So to add anything in a specific location, we'll say this like songs dot insert, and then you write the location you want. So I wanted the first location, and I know the first location from the left hand side is always 0, and I'll insert the values, let's say to be AR. And now let's see my songs. So you can see AR Rahman, Arijit, Arman, AR Rahman. So that is what I say, that A in a list, the elements can be repeated. Okay, it can be repeated after there. Okay, this is like on this. Now a list has got some several methods to work on. Okay, now let's say that I just want everyone is good over here. Still, let's say that I want to remove some of the singles, I want to make it only a combination of 2 or 3 like that. Okay. I want to remove someone. So let's say for removing anything in like list, you have some methods over there. So let's say I want to use the remove method. So I'm removing this to remove. Let's say I'm removing Arman. Okay. And now let's see my list. That is like Arman will be removed from that place. Okay. That is like how it works on. So this is a method like you can remove anything from the list. Let's say there is another method that is called as pop. Okay. Now every time this pop, what will do, except the dictionary, every time this pop will remove the last element automatically. Okay. You don't have to specify anything. If you specify, then it will remove that element. But if you just write pop and function, then it will remove automatically the last element. Let's say you are writing songs.pop. So automatically it says that Sonu has been removed. So now if you see your songs, you'll see like no Sonu is there, right? So this is how it works on. Okay, fine. So like these are the things how like your list works on. Okay, now let's say I recently got an interest. I'm not having actually. So let's say I got an interest in listening some English songs, right? So I deleted all, I cleared all my this Bollywood songs list, right, or Bollywood singers list, right? So what I'll do, for clearing a list, you will have to just write songs and like clear. Okay, before clear, let me do one thing. Let's say there is some other person who is having the same interest like for me, right? Like exactly he's having interest on Arijit, he's having interest on Shreya, he's having interest on Darshan and AR Rahman. Okay, not on this Vishal. Okay, so what to do, he's having interest on AR Rahman, like he's having interest on this particular range. Okay, now let's say is my friend and let it write his name. Okay, let's just take, it's like, let's say this is Chris, and what he's actually having, he's having interest in the songs which starts from this 1, and I see he's having interest from the 1 to this -1. Okay, that is 1 from the -1, it is from the starting 1 to the -1, and if I'm writing -1, that means that -1 will not come actually. The element still -2 will be coming on. So he's having an interest on this one. So if I see this Chris over there, so I'll see that he's having interest on Arijit, AR Rahman, Shreya and Darshan. Like you can slice on the things like similar. Now let's say there is his brother and he also have the same interest in all these things. So let's say this is to be Morris over there, and this is Chris Morris actually. So this is Morris and I say he's having the same interest, so I'm not making any indexings over there, I just write a copy. So for making a list a copy, you can just write it like the list name and dot copy, and that will be copied up. Okay. And now let's see the Morris, and you'll see that he's also having the same interest. Okay. So now my things are clear, and I want to just clear all my things. As I say, I got interested in the Hollywood ones. So to clear any list, you will just write the list name and then the clear function, and then it got clear. Okay. Now when you see your list name, so it will like a blank list, nothing is there. Okay, that will be like a totally blank. This is how it works out. Okay, fine. All right. Okay, so let's just take now the numbers list. Now let's say it is having some 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Now in the list, what more you can do? What are the more things you can do on, right? You can say, you can find the max. You can even find the maximum thing from a list. Like you write max of num, you'll be getting a maximum number, that is 10. You say a mean of this num, think mean will not work. Okay, so yeah, that mean will not work. You'll have to pass something. Okay, yeah, let me give just an example. We'll be doing this one. Don't worry, you have this module in this course. So let's say I'm finding the mean value. So mean value is like 6.0. Okay, don't go with this. What if not fine? Okay, just focus on that. Like mean, you are getting right. Similarly, you can find the minimum value of this num, and like the like you can say the sum actually of this num. And like these are the things you can write in the list. You can even delete a list. For deleting a list, you just write delete and then the list name, and that will be deleted. Okay. So after deleting, if you just write and run these things to write, just print it on, that time will not get over there. Okay, that time it will say that name is not defined. Okay, that will happen. So this is like all things which are like in the list, and that is how it is used. Okay, so any queries on the list, or like any kind of questions in the list, any problems? Like for the list also, you can just write, you can just write like help of this list, L-I-S-T, and that will be right here. So, okay, one more thing. So let's say you're having 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and it's happened. You're having something in the list. And you want to count the number of 1. That is 9. Nice. So count works at like similarly, index will work the same as in like. So if you see this index, if you see the index of this, what again you will see the difference. You will see the only index value of the first element. Okay, always. So there is like get size of set items and everything. Now this get size of is important actually. Okay, let me discuss that. For getting a size of any element or any kind of list, so you'll have to import your system module, and then you can write sys.get_size. I think it's get size of just like that. Okay, so get size of, let's say we have cleared everything, right? So there is nothing left to find the size. Okay, let's say this is R, and that is having some numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0. So I'm saying get size of this 1. So see what comes. That is, 1 is having a size of 28 bytes. Okay. Similarly, I say 31. So 31 is also having a size of 20. Okay. So this is how it is like work. Okay. See that these are having the size of 20. So let's say I'm writing 310. Still it is having a size of 20. So if I write it like 310.21 and like that. Now the size has been, let's make more values. Okay, so float has some fixed size by in bytes, integer has some fixed like size in bytes. Okay, so if I'm saying that if this one is having a size of 28 bytes, so every 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 will have, every element will have the size of 28 bytes. So if I want to find the size of particular element, or like not particular, the whole list. So the size of this whole list will be get the size of 1 multiplied by the length of whatever there is in the R. Okay, that will be the size of this whole list, and the size of whole list is 280 bytes, because 28 is of 1, so you are having 10 elements there, so obviously you will be having 280 bytes of spaces. Alright, clear? I think it should be clear, right? Any doubts in this one? Anyone having any doubt in this bytes and like all those things? Okay.
No, sir.
Fine, good. So like this, they have cleared a copy, count, extend, index, insert, pop, remove. Reverse is also there. You can just reverse any list over there. Okay. That is all about list. Now we will go to another kind. that is your tuples. Okay. Now let's say this tuples or this tree, and let's write tup alias tuples and this tree. So tuples are also, guys, a collection of heterogeneous data. Okay. But the only difference is, okay, let me discuss something more about this list. Let's say this S is, or this R was having, if I say R of 0, so I'm getting some numbers, right? You can index on like things R 0 to 3, so you'll be getting something over here. So if I say, if I just say on, if like 0 to 4, you're having some characters over there, and 0, you're having some values, right? So like, where it is, yeah. So if I say like for the R of 2, and I'm saying this values to be like replaced. Okay, if I see my R, so I can see like in the second position, that is the first 0, 1, and in the second position. So I'm finding like in the second position, the values from the 3 has been replaced by this particular replace string, right? So in a list, you can edit, you can like replace things. Okay, that's why lists are always called as mutable. Okay, lists are always mutable. But now we are going to study the tuples. So these tuples are actually immutable. Okay, that is, these cannot be easily like changed or like easily replaced or editable. Like these are not actually editable. Now you can just add on the things only if you are having a tuple. Okay, that is, you can. Now let's say we are making a tuple. Now always tuple will store values in some like first brackets. Okay, we will always be getting the values of this tuple in the first bracket. Like for the list, we are having the values in the square brackets, and this one you are having the values in the first bracket. Okay, so let's say you went on like, let's say you went on for marketing and like made some of the list of elements you are going to shop on, and you are having the bill, right? So once your bill is made, can you do the changes in that? Like, can you like when you bought the things, right? And when you ask to pay the bill, and the like vendor gives you a bill, like gives you the receipt that this is a bill, and you see the like costings over there, and can you now that can you will you say that okay, remove this particular element and give me the new receipt over there? That's very shy, right? So let's say this is the cost of the elements you have bought. Let's say this is 12.4. Okay, nothing comes in 12 rupees now. So let's say even if you buy a pen, it will cost you 25. So let's say this is pen. Let's take several values random. Okay, so like this is cost of some elements you have bought on, right? That is nice. So if you see the type of this cost, so what you can find that this is a kind of tuple, and that's obviously correct. Okay, that is nice one. Okay, right, fine. So now how to see that which element, or if I see that what was the maximum price I gave to one particular element, that would be max of cost. So the maximum price I paid for a particular element is 87.9 rupees, approximately 88 rupees. Okay, and the minimum would be the cost, that is like good 25 rupees the minimum. That's nice. And if I want to see what was the total expenditure of this costings, what was the total of this, that would be obviously the sum of this cost, and the total cost was 293.5. fine. Okay, now what I'm saying that like let's say you ask the vendor, okay, give me that, give me one more particular element, right? So you will go to add up the things here, you will go to add on the particular like value. Okay, so what do you say, like you don't have any methods of append, extend, and any such thing over there. How you will add, you will say, will you say that cost plus 50, that is you want 50 more over there. If you this do this thing, that it will say that it cannot concatenate any integer to tuple. That is, it cannot add any particular thing to the tuple. Anything you cannot add. Only tuples can be added in the tuples. Only it is a tuple, then only you can add a tuple to that. Okay. So we'll try to make this 50 a tuple. Okay, this 50 a tuple, we'll try to make this one. So to make one individual element as a tuple, what you do is, you just write the parenthesis over there and put a comma. If you don't put a comma, it will still remain as an integer, okay? So if you write a comma over there, that defines that this is a tuple. So I'm adding 50.0 to this cost. And let's store this. So done, right? That is done. So if I see my cost, I can see 50.0. Now will I see that what was the total cost and what was the maximum cost and similarly the minimum cost. So now it's like 343, maximum is still 87.9 and the minimum is 25.0, and that is like a good thing, okay. So in tuples, you can just count on the things, like you can just count how many elements are present on and that too much, okay. That is like very good. Like in tuple, you have very less things to study on, right? If you see your tuples, end up here, right? That's only the thing, only this much thing, right? You can add on, like you can use self plus values, it contains, and these are the basic functions over there, don't go with this. So you have only this count method, the index method, that's it, nothing else. Okay, that is like where your tuple comes to end. So tuple is used. Now let's say that the vendor has given a wrong value. Okay, he has given a wrong input in this 45.3. It should be around, I checked the bill and I said that it should be 35.4. And this is 45.3. We said, okay, I might have done the mistake. Let me correct it. Okay, so now the receipt has been made and now he want to make it some correction over there, right? Now let's say this is a tuple and you want to make some correction in this. You want to actually make this second value as 34.5 or any such value. So 34.5 is the value, you want to replace it by that, right? Okay. So what you will do, you will say the cost of this 3. That is 67.4, huh? Okay, 2, I think that's 2. So, yeah, 45.3, 134.5. So, will you say that this is equal to 34.5? That is, tuples does not support any item assignment. That's a problem. So, how you will assign? You will have to convert this in a list first. Okay, that is what you will do. You will say this cost will be first as a kind of a list. And then I can do this step of cost of 2 and I can replace, and once I replace it again I will make it as a kind of tuple. Then I can just print on my cost and I can see now the values have been changed to 34.5.
So this is the like method how you can change on things, how you can work.
Okay, this was all the two of the like three. We have discussed the numeric type, we have discussed the string type, we have discussed the list type and the tuples type. Now we have two more types like the set and the dictionary. I'll try to finish both of them today so that we can get hands on the data science from tomorrow. Okay, so see guys, set is something like there you have a collection of data. Okay, again a collection of data. So a tuple can also have duplicate data, a list can also have duplicate data, a list is a collection of heterogeneous data type, tuple has also same, right? The only difference between a list and a tuple is like lists are mutable and tuples are not mutable. Okay, and this is a very important question every time you will be asked somewhere, and also in the examination one MCQ will be there where you will be asked like difference between the major difference between a list and a tuple. And you will be given some options, 4-5 options over there, and out of them one will be correct one. Okay, so obviously that will be correct, that list are mutable and the tuples are not, right? That will be the correct option. So obviously that will be correct. Okay, so that is how you like go with the things. Okay, so these are the string, list and tuples. I think you might have been clear. Any doubts in three of the data types to anyone? Any step not understood or right? Anything, sir? like which is not clear, you can just ask them. Okay.
Everything clear, sir.
Some person is clear with everything.
Then just be clear, I think. Okay. Now we are going to read about this set. So what are sets?
Sets are collection of some unordered heterogeneous data types.
Okay.
And do not have any of the duplicate elements. That's it. Okay. That is, these are again a collection of various hetero type of data, right? Hetero data types, you can say. But here the elements is only written for one time. You can't make any such duplications in the set. Okay. You can't store anything like that. So we'll give an example for that too. And it is always written, like you see the basic definition is not there, I think. Fine, okay. So, sets, nice. Another collection of data, some like non-duplication objects. Let's say you have some numbers over there, okay? You have numbers and you are saying this again as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. Like this. You have given some values, okay? And now you see your num. First you see the type of this. I see the length of this num. That is only 5. Okay, that is only 5. Okay. So you are getting some, like you have written some of the numbers right there, 1, 2, and a lot of things. But you are getting the length as only 5. Why? Because you have made some duplications, right? You have made some of the values duplicate. And that is the reason why you are getting only 5. Because when you see your num, you will see that this is having only 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because the 1 has been duplicated, 2 has been, 4 has been, 3 has been, and 5 has been. So duplications are not allowed in this set. This is a very practical example because like you can say like, let's say this is an Instagram username. Okay. So once a username has been defined, let's say once a username as, let's say Anoop underscore 123. Once this username has been taken, you will not get this username anytime again. Okay. Anytime you will not be getting this username. Let's say this Anoop has been born in 12 and let's say year to be like 93, 94, anything. Okay, 1293. It's 12 date of birth and 93 as date of year. Similarly, let's take different names and we'll give you a very practical example of this thing. So let's say this is Satyam Kumar and 03. Or .03. Alright. Let's say these are the two username I'm having on. Okay. And I'm creating a like, let's say this user. And I want to log in Instagram. I want to create an account in Instagram. So like while creating, you are asked to choose a username. Yeah, that happens actually. So let's say you are like using this. So if there is the username in this one, we'll see username is already existing, right? And if not, if it is not there, then what I'll do, I'll add this username, right? If it is not there, then I'll add it, right? So for adding a username, see, right? Like for adding something in the list, like kind of set, you use a method that is called as add add. That's normal one, right? So you will say that in username, you will be adding the value of the user, right? That is a simple process, simple program. So let's say I want this username. Let's say I'm writing Anup. And I'm saying this 1293. So you'll get a prompt out there. This username already exists. And you can't even write on good things, right? You can't even like take this username because this exists actually. So I'll have to choose something different. So let's say I'm using mine. So py.pro, and this now you see your username. You can see that the element has been added up. Now you can again see, now with this example we have seen three things, right? That is, element cannot be duplicated in set, okay? If you add anything, to add anything you will use add, and whenever you add anything, as I said, a set is an unordered collection of data. You can see the value can be added anywhere, first place, second place, last place, anywhere it will be added up, okay? So this is your username, right? That is like a simple one. Now if I run this and I say this to be a particular this I'm using, and I have made account, and like let's say this to be there, copy, paste. Now the problem is that once a username is defined, and every time if I'm running it, so this will be a kind of error. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let's cut this, because let it be there, and let this add the value of this underscore pi dot pro underscore and paste it. Now if I say if I'm adding this particular value, I've made my account and I'm adding this. Let's say the username has been taken. So like this happens every minute and every second, some like every minute, not seconds. So in every minutes or like every hours, someone make an account in Instagram. Because if you see the mobility report, you'll get to see that. So like this happens and every minute, like the set is like generated, and the values actually get reshuffled, right? The values actually get reshuffled. Like if you see your user name, so you can see the values every time it get reachable. Now it is not happening. So like if you want to add up the same thing, you will not see it for the two times. Sorry, there is a missing. You're not going to see it for two times because this is actually present from previously inside that. Okay, so that will not be good. Like this set can be used many places, in many of the places, right? That is the first one. To add any particular thing, you can use add. Now let's say you want to add up some multiple key or multiple like values in a set. So for that, what you'll do, we'll use a method that is called as update. Okay, that is called as update. Now if I use a practical implementation of this update, so let's say where you can use this things, any example where you can use in practical life where you can use this update. An example for that?
Flipkart.
Flipkart. Like what?
Like adding items to the cart.
Adding items to the cart. But in particular item can be added for one more time, right? you can buy a same thing for more than three times, like you can buy a same three same product for three times or three like three items of them, or three pieces like for that particular product, you can buy like that. So anything which is not like repeated, a practical example.
Mobile numbers.
Yes, like mobile numbers. These can be taken on, like if you are making any account, you are having that mobile number. So that can be done, right? Okay. So, let's say
whatever username.
Username, yeah, that can be done. Right? Let's say these are some mobile numbers. I'm taking some random numbers. Zero should not be there. Okay. And this is actually a set with some mobile numbers. And you want, like, you went to see the college attendance and you saw some of the students who are like bunking the classes, right? Everyone does, right? I also do in my college times. Right? So, like, you like the teacher is making, like, you can say he admin staff is making the list of students who has bunked the classes. So, to avoid, like, to add a same number for two times, why to engage my works, right? So, what I'll do is I'll just add up the things at once. So there you can use this update method. And then you can just say this to add up things. Okay, just have them more. I think this is good. And you can even write these things, right? Now let's say I have again written this thing. Update it. So if I see my mobile, how many numbers should be there? 5 or 4 or 3 or 2, how much?
5.
5. Okay. Alright. So it's 4. Sampan, yeah, like you have to see, you should have a good, like, vision.
I'm extremely sorry, the last one is 2.
yes. No problem, actually. That's why I say the options 5, 4, 3, 2. Alright. So see, the last is having the same value as the first one is having, so that will not be like repeated, right? That will be a same one. So it will be easy for the professor to call every number over there and then say your like child is having bunking, your child is bunking the classes. So for more, exactly for one time the call will be like given, okay? Okay, so this is like when you want to add up then things, multiple values, update, single value. Now to remove up the things, you have again, like here you have three methods. You can use remove, you can use discard, you can use pop. Okay. Now let's say.
So I have a doubt.
Yes.
Like you said that sets are immutable, right?
Mm-hmm.
But over here also, like we are able to add and do all the things like in the list. We are able to do everything.
Now,
just like the list.
Let's say. This is mobile of 3, and you see, you can index the values over here. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Fine. Alright. So these are the list of numbers. Let's say I have called this first number, and I want to remove this. Right? I want to remove this. So what I'll say, I'll just copy this. And I'll say I have contacted this person, I want to remove this. And if I see my mobile, that has been removed. Okay. Now you want to contact some three numbers. That's nice. Now let's say you again contacted this particular number. Okay. And you again want to remove this. So now we are using discard, and I'll let you know what is the major difference between that. So you remove that one, and now you see your mobile, and that is okay. Now discard has a disadvantage also, right? Why discard advantage? Let's see this. So mobile dot discard.
Now you will think that okay, like you have removed something, right? But it's not, because when you see it, hasn't gave any kind of errors. Let's see. Let's take that you have taken this number and you said that you have deleted this, and by mistake you have added one more zero over here. And like it is obvious, you will not see it again because you know like this card will remove. Okay, by mistake you have added a 1 0. So now you are like, okay, my things are clear and only one number is left, only one phone number is left to call up. Now when you will check this for mobile, you will see again there are two numbers. So that will be a problem, right? Because this discard will not raise any error even if a number is not there in the set. But if you do with this remove, if you do this, the same thing with the remove, that will give you an error. It will say that this is not present actually in the set. So if you use this zero, it will be this, like it will be worked on. Now only one particular is there. So one element is there and one method also left. So let's say this to be used by pop. POP, pop ons. Okay. This will remove the last element. And then nothing is been left, so that will be removed actually. And this is mobile. And this is the blank set now. So you can even copy things like dot copy, you can clear up the things like dot clear and all those things you can use on, right? You can use these things to like work with the same methods like you can do it now, okay? Now some mathematical steps are there in this set actually, okay? So those are like called as union, intersection, difference update, intersection update, like these things. Let's see what are those things. Okay. So, let's say you're having A and this B. So, you might have read what is union. If we find the union of two sets, if I say B A union B. So what is that? Actually, you create everything, like you create a set of the elements, combined set of things, right? And if I say a dot update, what if I use this update one? Remember, b. If I see my a, that will be having all the elements now, right? Because I have updated the b in a. So to add up the things, to combine on two values of a set, you can use union, and even if you can use this update method, both will work over there. Okay. Okay. Now, if I say a dot intersection of b, what I will get? 3, 4, 5. Why? Because a is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, b is having 3, 4, 5. So what are the element commons in both of the sets, like for the A and for the B also? So the elements common in both of them are 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. Okay, alright. I think we might have to be clear with that. Okay. So 3, 4, 5 is there with this common one, right? You can write A and B. So that is also an intersection like sign, A and B. You say A, B. And you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so like these are the things which you can say, like the union and intersections and a lot of things. Okay. Now there is something called as difference. If I say a dot difference b, so that is, if I find the difference of a with respect to difference b, what I'll find that only 1 and 2, right? Only this 1 and 2 are different from the B. Rest everything is present inside the B. Rest 3, 4, 5 are present inside this B, right? So only 1 and 2 are different. So that is your difference. But if you say A dot difference and you update that difference according to this B. So now what happens when you see your A, you will see 1, 2. You will see B, you will see 3, 4, 5. And now what happens? The A will only have 1, 2. Okay. The A will only have this 1, 2. Why? Because this difference update actually removes the difference.
actually keep the difference and remove the uncommon, like remove the common one. Okay. So the common was 3, 4, 5 and A has been removed by the, like the 3, 4, 5 has been removed from the A. That is how it works. Okay. So like these are some of the common things of set you can do. You have frozen set. Frozen set is actually where you can't just add up things and you can just delete things over the, from there. Let's say you have written the frozen set and this is the frozen set and let's say this is like 1, 2, 3. So once you have created a frozen set and you want to, let's say you want to write it, let's say this x is, okay. If you see your x, that will be a frozen set of 1, 2, 3, right? And let's say you are saying that you want to remove something like 3. That will not work. Because frozen set will not allow you to delete anything, to add a pin. If you want to like add 5, still, okay? So frozen set is the kind of thing where you store like data births, because if I let's say that if someone has born in 1996, or 1997, 98, 99, if someone has born, or like let's say if someone is born today, after 10 years also his date of birth will be today itself, right? That will not be changed. Okay? So for the things which cannot be changed with the respect of future, we take these things in like kind tuple, or as tuple is also like can be editable. We take these things in mostly in the present tense. Okay. That is not like editable. You can create a copy of that, you can do all those things, you can edit on the copy, then like you can go with that. But you can't create a just like say you can't just modify the things. Okay. Once created, it has like created, that's all. Okay. So this is all about like set, what you can do. Okay. Now we are going to dictionary. Now dictionary has got something like, here you have KVP. Okay, KVP stands for key value pair, right? That is key value pair, and then you work here as, and here indexing works on the keys. Okay, you write the keys name, you get the values. You write the keys and you get the values. Okay. That's nice. So dictionary is defined, it's a collection of some like ordered data. Okay, that is like you have values and you can do, let me just define something over there and you can get more understanding. So you have one key and you have one value. So sorry. So the thing which should be focused on while declaring a dictionary is that a dictionary should never have a duplicate key. That will actually make a problem. If you write for that, that will make a problem actually. Why? Let's say this is k1 having a value of v1. Let's say this is k2 having a value of v2. Now, or let's say this is also k1 and having a value of v2. So if I see my type of x, I'll see that this is like dictionary. Okay, that's nice. Right? Okay. If I see the keys of my dictionary, the keys will be only k1 and k1. Alright, that will be k1 and k1. But if you see your x, or if you see your k1, that is the problem why it is like not same. That is, I gave one space over there. Yeah, now it's okay. So now if you see, you will only see k1 over there. Okay, only see k1. Now if you see your x, that is k1 of v2. Now why this k1 of v1 not came? Because you have made keys safe. That is k1. So never make duplicate keys. That will raise errors in your program. Okay. So this is a dictionary. This is a key. This is a value. Okay. If I want to see the value of k1, what I'll say? The x of k1 is v1. Understood? The x of k2 is the v2. Alright. This is like how you index. So you index on the basis of keys and you get the values over there. Okay. And this is like the keys. Similarly, you can just write x dot values and you can get the values from there, right? So there is one another term called as item. So actually in the item you get the key and value, one sibling. There you get everything at once, like K1 is having value 1, K2 is value 1. Okay. This is like you go with the dictionary. This is how you make a dictionary of the things over there, right? Now, dictionary is not completed. Okay, let me discuss some of the things. I think I have skipped those things actually. So, let's see like what is loops, okay? Now, loops are something which should we say like we go on repeating when we go on repeating some tasks, like you consider the clock, consider the hands of a clock. What it does actually, it keep on rotating, like it keep on rotating until a specified condition is met. And what is the condition? Until its battery goes down, right? Still it keeps on rotating and rotating, okay? So that is loop. And we also work in, everyone works in like kind of loop, right? You get up every day in the morning or like in time, afternoon, evening, whatever your choice is. So you get up like and you work and whatever your work is. So what you do, your work, and then you go to sleep, right? That is the daily routine you are following. That is a particular loop. So this is a condition. Until and a specified condition is met, you keep on working with these things, right? So that is like something like in this year, what happened? One condition came as the COVID disease and it breaked out the loop actually. Everyone's like loop has been breaked out, right? Everyone's condition breaked out for a particular limit and then it has again started, like the loop again started. So we'll see the loops, okay? So loops, okay. So there are two kind of loops, like for loops and while loops in this Python, okay? You have this for and while loops. Okay, so condition statements, I think you are clear with that because you're having if and else and how you deal with that. I think you are clear with that. Okay, so now we'll just try to understand the loop. So loops are of two kinds, for loops and while loops. Okay, so for loops is sometimes where we use for loops, the conditions, or you can say the statements or conditions where you know actually how many number of times you want to run your code, how many number of times you want to write anything, that time you will be using loops. Now loops are something which makes our work very easy every time. Okay, and these are very important in every aspect, right? So while is something where it will run until a given condition is true. Okay, once the condition becomes false, it will come out of the loop. Okay, so let's say I say that this I is equals to 0. Now this I will be my counter, okay, this will be counter, like it will be counting on the things. So I is equals to 0, and now I say this while I is less than 10. So while I is less than 10, I'll say I, or I'll just print on I, and once it is like not less than 10, I'll just print that I is no longer less than 10. Okay, so this will go on like printing till this print I, let's say this print I. So I will be printing, the value of I will be printed out. Now it's 0 and it will go in the loop now, okay? I'll have to write one more thing. So after the printing, what I'll do, I'll do some assignment operators here. I'll use some assignment operators and I'll use plus equals to 1. Now what happens is, see, this I is equals to 0. Now while I is less than 10, while this is less than 10, what happens, it will be printed here that print I, and that will be printed. Right? Let it be any value we'll be getting here. For now it's 0, so 0 will be printed there, right? Now what you are doing next, that we are doing 0 plus equals to 1, that is you are making the value of I to be incremented by 1. So every time this will come, and how many times it will run, now value is 1, so this 1 is less than 10, correct statement, this will be done. Now again 1 will be added, 2 is less than 10, 3 is less than 10, and it will go like 9 is less than 10. Now once this 9 becomes 10, and once this 10 is less than 10 will come, this will be a false statement, and it will come here and it will say I is no longer less than 10. So if you run this, it will just take microseconds, you can say, to run this your code. I'll tell you how to calculate some seconds of your code, how to calculate the calculations your program is taking. Okay,
So run this one, you can see like the value starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. As it reached 9, and this is said, now I is no longer less than 10. Because now 10 should not be less than the 10, right? That is how it is printed up, right? This is like, you know, like for the true conditions. Okay. Similarly, you can use these things to like print any tables also. Like let's say your i is equals 1 and you are saying while this I is less than equals to 10. Now I'm using equals to 10, right? You see why I'm using? Because I need to write some table till 10. Okay, so I can use like that. And I say to print I, or to print percent I, okay, percent I multiplied by I multiplied, let's take a number, it will be, let's say I'm writing the table of 10. So percent n multiplied by percent I, not percent I, actually it's percent d. So percent d multiplied by percent d is equals to percent d. And this is not looking nice, so let's make it this. No, it's okay. And let's write the percent values. So number when multiplied by the I will give the value of number multiplied by I. That's nice, right? And I'll assign this I to be 1. So when I see this, I'll see 10 multiplied by 1. Okay, that is well, your 10. 10 multiplied by 1, 10, 2 for 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and 10 multiplied by 10 is equals 100. That's nice. This is how you use while loops and you like this is how it is being like done. Okay, so you can also use like, let's say you want some inputs, right? You want some inputs like in the marks. So let's say you are taking marks in, no, don't take in integers. Print again and less. So you are taking an input of marks. Now if the marks is now let's just take it in a kind of string. Why? Because I'm saying that. Now if this marks, if it is in blank, if it is nothing over there, if it is blank over there, right? So there what we'll say, there where we exactly break on things. Okay, we'll just break. So to come out of a loop, we'll use break. Okay, I'll discuss this break. And if it is not like an empty one, we'll print good marks, right? Like that. So that would be equals to break outside the loop. So let's say you want to write some marks over there and you are writing 34. So that has been done, right? That has been done. Okay. So that has been printed actually, and that has been done also. So let's run this and this got in processing. So stop this, run this again, and this is how 34, and that is like you can see now good marks to be printed out, and this will now continue. Until the condition is true, right? Now the condition is true because this is not an empty one, right? And this will be printing and it will go and for an infinite loop. This is like the conditions how your loop goes for an infinite condition. And it will be like keeping on like printing, and this will be kept on processing. Okay, so you'll have to manually stop this. So you can like stop these things by using just a stop one, okay?
You can use these things. So these are the things which are used in a loop particularly. Okay. So let's say, so to come out from a loop you use break, otherwise you use continue from there, okay? So to coming out from a loop you use these two things. Once again. Okay, so like these things can be used in the loop, right? Let's say if you are writing num equals to 1, or sorry, yeah, let's say, and you are saying that while this is to be taken there, and let's say you are using while your num is less than equals to 10, you will say print the value of this num. And meanwhile, I'm saying this to be incremented by 1. If you see, you will be getting 1 over there, and that will be just like getting it printed, right? So while num is less than equals to, again, you will go to an infinite loop over there. So that is how it will be working, right? That is, num is equals to 1, and while the same conditions like you gave, and this is like, I'm showing you how you can get some errors over there whenever you write like infinite loop, okay? So that was to be a condition while I is like things over there, okay? You can use these things, right? So this is like a condition that is going on. And this situation happens like when you study artificial intelligence, when you work in computer vision and all those things. There you see these things happen on, right? There these things are actually happens. There you get some NumPy arrays, and that is how they work. So there was one problem, I think. I have made one mistake over there. I've taken I over there, that should be run num actually. Okay. So you can make this as just one, and while this is to be greater than, and then you can just go with an infinite loop with that. Okay, that can be done. So this is a state, like this is a condition where you get to an infinite loop, and you can see like values changing every microseconds. Okay, so let's take it to be 1. And this to be less than 10, and the values are, let it stop, and let it run again. So the values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, exactly correct, okay. Now, in between these printing, if I say that if anyhow the num, any times it becomes 3 or becomes 5, you just break the things, okay? Just come out of the loop. As soon as the number becomes 5, just come out of the loop. So see, you will have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? Like that. So like you can say, if you have 1 and you check for the condition. Now, if I'm checking here, like if my num is equals to 5, I'll continue, okay? I'll continue, and I print num, and I'll just initiate it. So what you can see that it is like 1, 2, 3, 4, and like 5 is there, but you can see it. While
Okay. So you can see, like, I have written num1 and num plus 1 equals 2. So what I'm doing is, let's take this as a 0. So in the first line, I'm initializing one value, incrementing one value. And then I'm checking, like, if the value is 5, I'll continue. I'll not come out of the loop. I'll just skip that value, right? That 5 will be skipped out. After 4, you can see like 6 has it come. Now, this is very important. Like, this concept is actually used, like what I said yesterday, right? For the Google quotes, okay? So, this concept is used, like any if similar value comes, we use continue and then we skip up those things, okay? So, this is for all the while loops. Similarly, you have like for loops, okay? Now, for loops are used for a fixed number of times when you want to run something in the for a fixed number of times you use for loops, right? So let's say I want to add some numbers, some 1000 numbers, okay? You want to add some 1000 numbers, so definitely I am not going to write 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and like that in the list, right? So that will be like taking a lot of time. Even if I divide the teams and I say there are some 100 number of people, you all write everything 10 10 10 10, and then we'll combine. That is like taking man work, and like everything will happen, a lot of time will be taken, right? So see, to avoid these times and to avoid the hard works, we actually use loops, okay? So let's say if I write this as x to be a kind of particular list, and I say this for x in range of what I said 1000 numbers, so I'll take 1001. Why? Because it will then take till the 1001, okay? And I'll say this x to append the values in x, okay? Let this to be xy, and then we'll I will then print first 50 values of x to make you see how it sees, how it like comes. So you can see like your x is having some 0 to 49, right? What you did is actually you made a variable and you took for 0 to some 1000 numbers, and you'll see the size if you want. Let's see the size. So let's say x is dot get size of this 1 multiplied by the length of x. So the size of x is 28,028. Nice. Okay. So this much bytes it's having. Okay, that's nice one. Okay. So that is like you're having things. If you see the length of x, how many elements are there? So there are 1001 elements, right? Starting from 0. So let's take it from 1. So we have 1000 elements over there, okay, and 28,000 like size, okay, they're having a size of 28,000, and this is your length. So if I just say I want to print some numbers like for their range of 40 numbers and like that. So you can see like we have appended a range of 1000 numbers in 1 minute. This is like how for loops are used, okay? So these are used in most of the cases. Like for like how it is used in dictionary, we'll see tomorrow, okay? So like this is a basic step, or you can say this is the basic structure of the data types you study on, okay? So tomorrow, let me stop your videos.